to the nations. You are listening to the world's number one Christian station, Worship Center Radio, the platform of champions.
Hi, I'm Deborah Smith. Baby Time is about being a teen mom and dad, pulling together resources and talking about parenting and so much more. So let's go into our show today. Hi, you're live with Deborah Smith for Baby Time and much more. This week we have a very, very special guest. From our It's Just For Me Center, we have our guest. He's our RN, Mr. Nurse Thomas. Mr. Thomas, you want to introduce yourself?
Hi, I'm Tom Frazier. I'm a registered nurse, and I'm here to hopefully give some good advice on prenatal care.
This week, we are going to start our series on talking about the first trimester, and this month, for the rest of the month, we're going to focus on different resources that are available for our teen moms and teen dad. And the resource of the month is going to be about baby items. Where can you secure free baby items? So next week, Markeisha Smith will be here in the resource corner talking about baby items. But today, we are going to talk about the importance of when you find out you're pregnant, that is called the first trimester. So, Mr. Thomas, Nurse Thomas, why don't you give us a little information about, before we get into the first trimester, why is it important overall to just get prenatal care? Because one of the myths is prenatal care is not important. So, is that true or not true?
That's not true. Prenatal care keeps you and your baby healthy. Babies who do not get prenatal care are 3 times more likely to be born with low birth weight and 5 times as likely to die than those mothers who get early prenatal care. So it's that important.
Now, I know you say that babies are born, if they don't get prenatal care, sometimes they're born with low birth weight. What kind of problems happen when they have low birth rates?
Well, with low birth rates, you'll find babies who are developed slowly, may have some developmental issues such as being able to, crawl at the proper age, and can also develop some mental health type issues.
Now, when we talk about mental health, do these issues show up right away, or do they start showing up, when it's time for school?
Well, actually, they probably show up right away. Your baby, your infant is not crying like it's supposed to, when it's supposed to. Your infant is not making that eye contact at the first couple of months like they're supposed to. And all those things are important as far as your baby's developmental stages.
Now, so when mom goes to the doctor for the first prenatal visit, I noticed that what kind of things are done at that first visit?
Usually on the first visit, the doctor, he gives you an estimated due date. He'll take some blood because he want to check for some things such as diabetes. He want to check your vital signs to make sure that you're not hypertensive or to check those things. Also want to check and see if you might be harboring an infectious disease, which can cause great harm to a developing infant. So all those things are important. And as the visits progress, you want to, measure your abdomen to see how you're growing. He want to get your weight and see that you're gaining weight at a proper rate. You don't want to gain too much weight, but also you don't want to gain too little weight because that would also affect the health of the infant.
So what happens, at the first visit, you talked about the doctor gives a prescription for prenatal pills. Why is it important to take those prenatal vitamins? Because so many women complain about prenatal vitamins.
Well, actually, prenatal vitamins, the thing about prenatal vitamins, there are multivitamins with the added folic acid. And what folic acid does is it helps develop healthy brain cells. And actually, even if you're not sure if you're pregnant or if you're planning on getting pregnant, you should start taking folic acid then. Because again, if you think about it, when the fetus develops, the first thing that develops is the head. If you look at a developing fetus at the very early stages, it looks like just a big round blob with the tail sticking out. That is the head developing. That's the first thing that develops on an infant. And in order for them to have good brain function and good spinal function, they need that folic acid to build those healthy brain cells. That's why it's so important to take folic acid.
So when we have all types of people who claim they can't swallow pills, they don't like pills, or the prenatal vitamins, they're horse-looking pills, they're really large pills. When we have those situations with women, is there a substitute vitamin that the doctor can order besides the regular prenatal pills?
Yes, it is. And if you're having problems in that area, just ask them. They have an excellent prenatal vitamin that's prescribed that's in like gummy bear kind of vitamins. They're easy to swallow. They're actually chewable. As opposed to trying to swallow those big awkward pills.
So you're saying that the prenatal vitamins now come in like a gummy bear, not just the gummy bear vitamins that we buy over the counter.
Right. They come exactly like those that you get for your children. Those prenatal multivitamins that are jelly. Fruit gel vitamins.
Oh, that sounds great. Now, you also mentioned that the doctor takes blood. Now, what are some, I know you mentioned that they're looking at diabetes, and I have a whole nother question about the diabetes, but what are some of the things that they're taking the blood for? Because it seems like at your prenatal visit that most of the time you're taking blood once a month.
Yeah, and the main thing that they are checking is your blood sugar. But they're looking for other things. They're looking for, like I said, infectious diseases such as STDs. They want to check for HIV and make sure that you're not HIV positive. Because if that was the case, then you could still deliver a baby, a healthy baby, but it has to be done in a certain way. So don't be afraid to be checked for, be checked for that. But they also, and it depends on your age as well, because if you're over 30 and you become pregnant, there are problems associated with that as well. And they will be looking for a certain possible genetic malformation. So that's why they would do those additional blood tests.
Now, I know with the blood test, so what about even teens? We know that teens have high blood pressure, diabetes. So why is it so important during a prenatal stage that when they do come to the doctor, they have these pre-existing conditions of diabetes, high blood pressure? Sometimes they do have infections. They find out on their second visit when they come back, they find out, oh, they have infection. So do the doctor prescribe antibiotics by then? And what about their pre-existing conditions?
Yeah, that's the important part of getting that care early and getting that early prenatal care, because if it's treated early, they can treat you on low doses of antihypertensive medications, antibiotic medications, or whatever it is that you need. That the doctors know which medications will cross the placenta, which ones won't. And they will prescribe that medication for you, and you can go on to develop. And then, every month, and particularly in the first trimester, they're going to draw blood, and they're going to check your blood pressure, and they're going to also check your weight. And they can determine just from that how the fetus is progressing and how you're progressing.
Okay, so let's get into the question. In the first trimester, what about drug use? How is drug use affecting a fetus? Because later on we're going to have a show about babies born with alcohol syndrome, babies born addicted to drugs. So we're going to have that down the line. But early on in the first trimester, when women are using drugs and drinking alcohol, how does that affect the fetus?
Well, remember I said at the early part, in early stages of pregnancy, the brain is the first thing to develop. And if you're testing positive for drugs or alcohol, it would affect that fetus's brain development. And there are conditions such as fetal alcohol syndrome, where they have some very serious developmental issues. Also, can lead to some birth defects.
Now, with these birth defects and fetal alcohol syndrome, and I know that you see it in the first trimester when the brain is developing, is once they find out they're pregnant and they have been abusing drugs and alcohol, when they stop using in the first trimester, does that give the baby a better chance?
Definitely. It gives them a much better chance. And so if you're using, and even if you suspect that you're pregnant, this is the time to stop. And if you're having trouble stopping, talk to your doctor. There are treatments and there are facilities that will help you kick the drug and alcohol habit, particularly alcohol, because when you withdraw from alcohol, it can actually become very serious for you and for the infant. So you may need support in that area. And anytime you try to quit, even with cigarettes, because remember, cigarette smoke, even secondhand smoke at early development can damage the baby's development, particularly the brain. So all these things, there are treatments and there are remedies for this, but you have to be honest with your doctor, let them know that you have this problem, and ask your doctor to help you get some help to deal with that before the baby develops fully and have even more serious problems.
And well, okay, so now that we've talked about some of those issues, what about some of the environmental issues? I know you mentioned secondhand smoke. A lot of times moms don't think secondhand smoke would affect them during their first trimester because the baby's not born yet. But what about when they're inhaling the secondhand smoke?
Well, evidence-based research has shown that secondhand smoke is actually more dangerous than firsthand smoke. Also, when you talk about environmental factors, we need to, if you have a cat in your home, there are conditions there are parasites and infections that live in the cat feces. So if you're changing the litter box, you should use gloves. But also, if you have rodents in your home, they carry parasites that can cause problems with the baby. And and even things like dust mites, roaches, and those kind of things could cause you to have allergic reactions. And when the baby is developing, cause problems with the baby as well.
Okay, wow, that seems like a lot. One of the things that, for audience, let me explain one thing. When Nurse Thomas talks about evidence-based means that there have been research done, and the research means evidence-based has proven that the research is fact. So when we keep mentioning the word evidence-based, that means that we are talking about facts. We're not talking about fiction or myths. The evidence-based means that there was a study done, and at the conclusion of the study, it was evidence-based that these are facts of things that can happen. And we're talking about the first trimester because the first trimester is truly sets the tone for the pregnancy for the next two trimesters. Now that I said that, what about women in domestic violence situations, especially our teen girls? Studies show that there is an increase of domestic violence among teen women, teen young ladies. So what happens when they're in these domestic violence, and I'm not just talking about physical domestic violence, but also verbal domestic violence that cause mental health. So how is that, those stressors play into the trimester of pregnancy?
Well, stress in itself causes problems for the mother to the point where they can actually cause the placenta to separate from the uterus. And this has also been found evidence-based. And just the stress itself on the fetus, it's you want your baby to be born healthy and happy, and you don't want that kind of stress for yourself or in that baby's life, because it could cause, you know, stress can cause physical problems. It can cause problems with your gastrointestinal system.
So does the stress cause problems? I know you said it caused problems with the mom, but is the stress also a factor with the development of the baby? Does the baby feel that stress from the mom?
Yes, definitely. The baby feels everything that the mother feels. And that's why they tell you, even in early pregnancy, to talk to your baby and keep them calm, and, you know, to keep them around, you know, pleasant type of things instead of stressful things, because it does cause a problem in their development, and more psychological development, but it does cause a problem in their development.
So as the brain develops in the fetus, and we talk about the importance of taking your medicine, going to making those monthly visits, what happens when the younger you are in pregnancy, under 18, why is that considered a high-risk pregnancy?
Well, that's a good question. A young person is not fully developed, and when I'm saying, I'm talking about their system has not developed fully to support an infant, can cause some very serious problems. A lot of young women are having to have C-sections because they cannot deliver vaginally because they haven't fully developed as a woman. But can I go back for a second?
Yes.
When we talk about environmental things? Also, chemicals in the environment.
Are you talking about cleaning chemicals?
Cleaning chemicals, okay. Insecticides. If you work on a job that use different types of solvents, if there's mercury involved, it can cause serious problems with the developing fetus.
Okay. Well, we're going to take a little station break and give Mr. Thomas a little time to catch his breath since we've been rushing into this. We shall be right back with you.
How y'all doing this evening? How y'all doing this evening? Do y'all want that bounce? Do y'all want that bounce? I say, do y'all want that bounce? That bounce?
Everybody wanna be like you, they want power and praise like you, but see there is no God like our God.
Like our God.
There's no one like you who gave their life like you, and who paid our price like you. Say
yeah.
There's only one God.
One God.
That's our God.
Our God.
There's no one like you.
First.
Who can touch like you?
Are back again. We were talking a little bit off air with our producer about bed bugs and different things like that. So we're going to ask Nurse Thomas again to talk about why bed bugs and other bugs in a home and chemicals, because that's something that I think that we really don't talk about a lot in pregnancy is the chemicals that you clean with. And sometimes when you live in a home that is probably not environmental friendly, smoke from cigarette smoke from marijuana. So can we talk about that just by a little bit more? Because I kind of like to home in on that as we begin to wrap up, that your environment, you talked about a stress-free environment, that not only should your environment be stress-free, but it needs to be as clean as possible.
Yeah, because and just things like simple things like washing your hands frequently can reduce the amount of infection, because everything that you touch, everything that goes into your body also goes into the fetus.
So it doesn't cross over the fetus like sometimes, you know, when you have different infections and different things, you worry about the doctor giving you certain antibiotics that. And so those antibiotics doesn't cross over into the fetus, but you're saying that some of the chemicals we use and getting bit by bugs and stuff will get in your...
Now, there are some medications that will cross the placenta, and the doctor knows which ones those are. And certain ones are your over-the-counter medications that can cross over and can cause damage. Things like paint thinners, paint fumes, even you don't have to be exposed to it, but just the fumes, bleach, mercury, all these things that are toxic to you is toxic to your baby. So imagine you're in the room and you clean up and you smell all that bleach, those fumes. It kind of shortens your breath and makes you want to get out of the room. Well, guess what? When your breath is short, when you're not getting the oxygen that you're supposed to be getting, guess what? The baby, the fetus is not getting the amount of oxygen it needs also. And the fetus needs that oxygen for that brain to develop fully.
So as we talk about the first trimester, we've covered the importance of really going to the doctor as soon as possible. And ladies, that's not waiting until you're 26 weeks. That's when you first find out. We talked about the importance of taking your vitamins. The doctor takes your blood to see if you got any type of infection so they can treat that in your pregnancy. And the reason why when you have pre-existing conditions such as diabetes and high blood pressure, that even itself makes it very important to go to the doctor. And cleaning supplies. Wow, I just did not figure in the cleaning supplies as a factor in pregnancy and in your environment. So as we talk about our first trimester, and we're probably going to visit the first trimester a little bit more next week, because each week we're going to go into different trimesters. And so I want you young people to take notes. Call in next week if you got any questions from this show. We're going to try to get Mr. Thomas to come back in and talk about this, because I won't be able to answer the questions, but he will be. And so we're going to always talk about these different trimesters. And next week, our resource corner will talk about baby items. But I think next week, our resource corner, instead of talking about where we could get baby items, next week, our resource corner will talk about what's the best cleaning supplies to use in the house when you first find out you're pregnant. So that will be in our resource corner next week. And we will get that information also out on our website. So remember, if you are pregnant, if you have an infant, you can always call It's Just For Me Center, the Maternal Infant Health Program, at area code 313-868-4380. If you have questions, you could call us here at the radio station. But remember, check us out, listen to us, and save this show, because this show is really interesting about what happens during the first trimester. Nurse Thomas, is anything you want to wrap up with us and talk about?
Yes, and you mentioned getting early prenatal care. Actually, I would stress that even before you decide to get pregnant, that you start taking care of yourself then. Talk to a physician. Start even before you get pregnant on prenatal vitamins. And eat white bread, believe it or not. White bread contains lots of folic acid. Take care of these things before you get pregnant, and so that when you do get pregnant, you're well on your way. Also, going back to the environment, the cleaning supplies, if you wear protective gloves when you're using certain chemicals, it's fine. But if they put out a gas like bleach or ammonia and those kind of things, then you want to just avoid them altogether.
Okay, so as we talk about our teen girls, who suddenly find themselves pregnant, these are some of the steps that they can take as they find out changing their eating habits. What about eating? If we got a quick minute, what about some of the hot sauce they're eating during pregnancy, some of them hot chips, you know, energy drinks? What about those kind of things when they find out they're pregnant? These are some of the things they just need to cut out?
Well, hot sauce, I don't know. But my thing is, you know, with food, be careful, particularly with fish. Certain fish has a lot of mercury. You don't want to eat fish that come out of Detroit River for sure, because of the pollutants that are in the water. But you want to make sure that fish, and not just fish, but all meats are fully cooked. You want to eat vegetables, fresh fruits and vegetables, whole grains such as rice. Oatmeal is good. All of these things are good. Avoid fatty foods. Avoid too much sugary foods or too much carbohydrates, because you don't want to put on weight too fast. And that's one of the things that the doctor is going to check. And each time you go in, they're going to check your weight to make sure that you're gaining weight at a regular pace and that you're not gaining too much weight, because that can also be stressful for the fetus. And remember, most of the things that you consume, the baby consumes also. You don't want a baby who is too large. You don't want a baby who's born with diabetes. You don't want a baby that's born with certain problems that come with your dietary habits. So be careful what you eat.
And what about one of the things, eating non-food items? That has come up a lot at the maternal infant health program, talking to women when we do their assessments, of eating clay, heavy on starch, eating things that are not healthy for you or not good for you and were not made for food.
That's called pica. It's it was very common years back. Women used to eat a lot of starch and those kind of things. But if that's a problem for you, you might want to look at substituting those foods for things like carrot sticks, celery sticks, something that you can eat that's finger food, that's quick to eat, but also it's going to be healthy for you as well. Because remember, starch is a carbohydrate, and starch breaks down in your body as sugar and is stored as fatty acids. And that can cause you to gain a lot of weight, and that can cause problems with the fetus.
Okay, everyone, thank you for having us in your home today. Remember, you can call us at the agency, It's Just For Me Center, at 313-868-4380. If you have any questions, give us a call. We look forward to talking to you next week and talking some more about the first trimester and visiting you on our website. Have a great evening, everyone.